Does the Gen 12 renderer make any difference to performance in 315? That is what this video is about. It's going to be a short one, you'll see why. Let's get straight into it. If you haven't watched the video all about the Gen 12 renderer and Vulkan panel at CitizenCon, I would suggest going and doing that first, because a lot of the stuff that we're talking about here is based on that. But the short version of what I talked about in that one and what's coming is that in 315, parts of the Gen 12 renderer are in. Hybrid approach is what they're going for. So some of their old renderer and some of their new renderer, which in the shortest way possible, should bring better performance because it allows them to use more CPU resources. That's the short version. Go watch the video if you want to see the long version. So some of that is in. So it's post effects, lighting effects, and fog. They are converted over to the new renderer. Does it make any difference? Here are the results. So I've done the testing at Lawville, and as you'll see, there's been a huge regression in performance, or so it seems. In reality, that isn't what's going on. This is a good example of why testing Star Citizen is, what some would say, an impossible job. I would say a challenging job. It takes a lot of results to get anything accurate. There's been lots and lots of runs here to get these results, but still, these results are potentially a little bit misleading. So we've got 314 results. Now, these are the results that I did when I did my RAM speed testing. So I did a load of testing, all different RAM speeds, and these are the same, they're the same. The RAM is 3600 on both the 314 and 315 PTU results. The only big difference is that at the point that I tested 314, it basically was completely dead. The patch was completely dead. There was nobody playing it. And so what that meant was that the servers were, when I was testing, I try to do this testing for each video that I make in a short amount of time as possible so that there's similar conditions. So effectively they were all done within a couple of days, and at that point in the patch cycle, hardly anybody was playing. And what that meant was that the results are very good. They're comparable because they're tested at the same time. But then when you compare the 314 live results, where the 314 was basically dead, to a quite healthy 315 PTU that people are excited to try out all the new stuff on, you then get these results. And you might say, wow, what, that doesn't make any difference. It's all about the renderer and the render thread, and we're being held back by CPU performance. And this is where the ridiculousness of Star Citizen testing comes into play, where you have to say, yes, that's true. And in some places in the game, that's true. But again, if you watch the panel, you'll know that the main thread is also sometimes a bottleneck. So if the server is busier, you get low performance. And that has generally been a known thing in Star Citizen for a while now. But here is a good example of that in play. So in reality, it's quite hard to see whether the Gen 12 changes have made any difference negatively or positively. But what we can safely say is they haven't. The little bits that they've put in so far, the hybrid approach they've got, hasn't suddenly solved anything. It's not fixed any issues in terms of the overall CPU picture. Now, obviously, this is just tested in one area in Lawville, so there might be other parts of the game which have seen more improvements from the changes that they've made. So if you see anything, please comment below, let me know, and I can go and do some more testing. But yeah, in general, I think we are going to be waiting for probably the full implementation of Vulkan before we see bigger improvements. But if you like this sort of video, you can like this one. And if you like this more technical look at Star Citizen, please subscribe. And also, you can now join and become a member and send me money over the internet every month if you are a very generous, kind person. So that's enough of this one. I'll see you soon. Bye.